So you might be curious if the exchange prices on an army base are a really great deal, or is it just a big ripoff when you could probably get a better price at Walmart? Let's do a little research and find out in this video. What's up, my friends? Welcome to an all new video. In this one, we're going to dive into whether or not the Army Exchange prices are really that great of a deal, or is it just better to maybe go shop elsewhere? Now, this video is actually inspired by individuals from the comments section. On a recent video, I talked about how veterans are now going to have access to actually go shop at an exchange on an Army installation or an Air Force installation, whatever, you know, they want to go to visit. And a lot of people in the comments were saying it's not worth it, that it's better just to go to Walmart because they're going to have better prices and the exchange is just a big ripoff and everything like that. So I thought I'd kind of do a little research and let's see if that's actually true or not. But before we dive into this, if you're not subscribed to this channel, go ahead and click on that subscribe button for me. Even consider clicking on that bell to get notified as soon as new videos go live, to include the live streams and join the awesome notification platoon. So let's do a little bit of a price comparison, shall we? Now, I was gonna actually just go to the local PX nearby, which is the Fort Carson PX, and I was just gonna kind of maybe like look at some different items, maybe take some pictures, see what the prices were, and then maybe go to Walmart and try to compare them. But I feel like the prices could fluctuate a little bit based on me being in Colorado, and if you're in California or Texas or Florida or whatever, then they could be a little bit different for what you have. So I figured I needed to find more of a neutral kind of playing ground here for the comparison of the prices. So what I did is I'm going to be looking at AFES Online, the exchange online website, to shop at items that you would have inside the exchange on an Army installation or even an Air Force installation, as well as comparing that to Walmart's website online. And then just to kind of throw it in the mix there, I'm gonna check out Amazon as well. Also, a little side note for those veterans that may not know, you can actually shop at the exchange website online now. You just have to go there, register, get verified, and you can shop and have items shipped to your house and take advantage of that tax-free items on the exchange website. You just can't go to a physical exchange if you qualify for that until January of 2020. So let's dive into it and let's kind of compare some items. So I have here the AFES website. I've also got on another tab the Walmart website, and then as well as Amazon. So let's shop for some stuff and let's kind of see how the prices kind of compare. Starting off on the AFES website, let's look for, let's say I need a new TV. So I found this pretty killer Samsung 82-inch OLED 4K UHD smart TV. Pretty sweet. Apparently the list price is $6,499.99. Of course, we all know that that's usually always inflated and kind of high, so it sounds like you're getting a better deal than you really are. So AFES is selling it for $4,399. So how does that compare to if I was to find this same exact TV on Walmart and Amazon? So here it is right here on walmart.com. They have the same exact one, the Samsung 82-inch 4K, the same exact model number and everything like that. And they are selling it for $4,497.99. So it's roughly $100 more than they're selling it for on the exchange. So far the exchange, roughly about $100 cheaper. That's also not including tax you would also have to pay on Walmart as well. So roughly probably a little bit more than $100 because you're also gonna tack on tax from the Walmart one. And just to show that there's no tax when you're shopping on AFES Online as well, I've added it to my cart just to kind of show it inside of here. So you can see inside there, right there, it says your benefit, no tax. So it's still the exact same price of that $4,399. So here it is on Amazon, found the exact same one. Again, the 82-inch, same model number and everything. On here, they have it basically the same price Walmart's selling it for, $4,497.99. So Walmart, Amazon, same price, the exchange, about $100 cheaper. And again, probably a little bit more because both these websites are probably gonna add on sales tax as well. Next, let's try something like playing some video games, right? Maybe I want a PlayStation 4 Pro with the 1 terabyte hard drive. So let's look for that on the Army Exchange and see how that maybe compares. So here it is on the Exchange website. It sells on here for $379 even. Let's see how that maybe compares to, let's say, Walmart and Amazon. So here it is over here on Walmart, the same one. It's also PlayStation 4 Pro, the 1 terabyte version, nothing extra included in it either. And this one is $361.95. So this one is actually slightly cheaper. Now, probably when you add it to sales tax, though, it might come out to be even. Let's maybe see what we can find out. actually comes out to be slightly more, because now with sales tax and everything, now you're paying $380 compared to a flat fee of $379. So, I mean, a dollar. It's gonna be a dollar more. It does have free shipping, so there's nothing extra for shipping. Again, if you're going inside the store, you don't have shipping either, but you do still have that sales tax. So about $1.52 more on Walmart just simply because of the sales tax. And then Amazon has it for $369. This is the same one, PlayStation 4, 1 terabyte. So it's actually more on Amazon. So it's the most on Amazon. The PX, you're really only saving a dollar in this case. So buying it online, probably great. Depending on the distance you have to drive to get to a PX to get it actually physically in a PX, may not be that great of a deal. Might be easier just to get it off Walmart. So that one's kind of an iffy one, I guess. So let's go with something maybe a little bit more family-ish. Maybe you're a parent out there with a newborn baby and you gotta get some diapers. So here I've got the Pampers Swaddlers. This is a 104 pack, size 4. And on AFEES, this is sold for $35.99. Let's see if we can find something similar or the exact same quantity on Walmart or Amazon. I know this one from experience, from trying to shop around as a parent myself, trying to find diapers or anything else, kind of this kind of similar kind of thing. It's always seemed like it's a pain in the ass to try to find the exact same quantity to try to compare with other stores. So we may have to do a little bit of math to kind of figure out which one is actually the better deal. Yeah, just as I expected, this one is the same size, same brand and everything like that, but it's 120 count compared to the 104 count. And for the 120 count on Walmart, it is $39.79. So, I mean, without really doing any math, I mean, that one kind of seems like it's slightly better. I mean, without sales tax being calculated in yet, because it's $39, it's only $4 difference, and that's 120 compared to 104, so you're getting more diapers, but it's probably kind of similar to that PlayStation. Once you add sales tax, now it's getting up a little higher. I don't know, I guess maybe we have to do a little math to really figure out which one is diaper for diaper, I guess, the better deal. But first, let's see what Amazon has. So Amazon has a 100 pack for $20. So yeah, let's kind of figure this out, I guess. So when we look at the exchange one, do a little bit of math-ish, it roughly looks like about 34 cents per diaper from AFEES with the 104 inside this pack. So that's about what it is per diaper, 34 cents. When you look at it from Walmart, it's roughly about 33 cents per diaper, so slightly cheaper, but again, that's still without adding sales tax. And then Amazon is roughly 20 cents per diaper without adding sales tax also. So they're close, you know, you add sales tax and everything to it. Yeah, now there may be a little bit the same as AFEES, maybe a little bit more than AFEES, but not a whole lot. Not enough to be hurrying up and rushing to the store to, you know, get in on this great bargain. So maybe now I'm in the market for a new camera. I currently shoot the videos on the Canon 70D. Not right now. Right now this is just a webcam, but I currently shoot on the Canon 70D. Maybe I want to upgrade to a nicer camera than that one. So let's compare prices. Starting off with AFEES, this is the Canon EOS 5D Mark IV. Very nice camera. Also very hefty price tag, $2,799. So how does that compare to Walmart and Amazon? Wow, so Walmart has it for $2,199. That's a $600 price difference. Yeah, they're gonna add tax onto it, but it's not gonna be $600 worth of tax. So that is an amazing deal compared to when you look at it on AFEES right there. And then Amazon pretty much has it for the same price as AFEES does of $2,799. So Walmart, even with tax, would be a much, much cheaper price. So let's do one more comparison. Let's say that I need maybe some new running shoes. So let's see what we can get from the site. So here at the exchange, I found these Under Armour Men's Hovar Sonic 2 running shoes. I even selected the size, a size 10, just in case that matters. It didn't seem like it changes the price really, but these ones are $80 at the exchange. If we jump over to Walmart, they have still, it says the Under Armour Men's Hovar Sonic 2 running shoe. They just have it in a different color. This one's in red compared to the other one being in blue. Also selected the size just in case it makes a difference. This one, however, is $159.29. So big difference compared to over at AFEES, where it's basically $100 cheaper. Now over at Amazon, I couldn't find the Hovar 2 Sonic 1. It looks like right here they have the first version. Maybe it's $74.25, but they don't have the exact same one. So I really guess can only compare that off of the exchange and Walmart in this case. And the exchange definitely has the better price on that one. So there you have it. Those are the kind of the price comparisons. It's kind of a little bit iffy here and there. You know, yes, there are some items on the exchange that are great deals, and then there's some items that aren't, you know, great deals. So I would definitely have to say that, you know, comparing it to a lot of the comments people were saying where it's a big ripoff and it's just better to go to Walmart, I can't say that's true, but I also can't say that the exchange is a great deal either. Hey, sorry to interrupt the video. I got some more information that after I put this video together, I didn't know about, and that is that the exchange actually price matches an item if you find it at a cheaper price somewhere else at a similar type of store. So that means, like that example of that camera, if you go into an exchange and you see that this camera is cheaper at Walmart, you show a representative on your phone or whatever that Walmart has it for a cheaper price, they will price match that item, and then you pay for that item at that price matched, but no tax. So it still ends up being a little bit cheaper because you're still not paying for that tax. There is some limitations like compared to overseas, but for the most part, especially like stateside, if it's a similar type of store like Walmart or Target or whatever, they will price match that as long as it's not something like a special Black Friday sale or Memorial Day sale or something like that. If it's just the normal price that they're selling it for, not a specific sale, then they will price match for that. That does change, I guess, things a little bit. That does essentially mean that the exchange is cheaper, but again, in the example I'm about to give, it kind of depends on a few factors still, even if the exchange has a cheaper price than somewhere else does. But a lot of people don't know about the price match thing, so this still gives a good comparison of in-store prices at the exchange compared to in-store prices at Walmart or somewhere else. You just now need to know that they price match and maybe spread the word to other individuals. Back to the last little bit of the video. It just kind of depends on the item. So you kind of have to shop around a little bit. And there's also other factors that kind of have to play into this as well as are you in a location that you can access an exchange? If it's going to take you an hour drive to go access that for the better deal, well, you're probably wasting your time because you're also having to spend the time to do that, plus spend gas to get there. So it may not in the long run be a better deal if you don't have an exchange near you. But if you do have an exchange near you, maybe it pays off to, you know, if you have an item you want to get, do a little research online, see what they are charging for it on the exchange compared to maybe Best Buy or Walmart or wherever it is you're going to shop at, and see if it's worth, you know, heading on base to hit up the exchange for that item. But like I said, I definitely can't say, like I saw in the comments, where the exchange is definitely a ripoff or it's definitely a better deal. It's just kind of depends on the item, really. And that's, you know, goes for a lot of stores anyways. You know, you go to Walmart compared to Best Buy and there may be some items that are cheaper here than they are at the other place. So that's really anywheres anyways. That's all I really kind of wanted to debunk, was that a lot of people were saying that the AFEES is either a great deal and it's way better to shop there, or it's a ripoff and it's just better to shop at Walmart or something, you know, there. So that definitely, I feel like, kind of debunks that. Down in the comment section, if you live near a military installation, do you think that you'll still take advantage of this and maybe sometimes shop at the exchange, or do you just rather prefer not to hassle with trying to go on base to go to the exchange? You'd just rather pay a little bit extra if you have to and shop somewhere locally at Walmart, Best Buy, or whatever maybe is convenient for you. Now, if you enjoyed this video, slap a thumbs up on it. You guys are awesome. Check out links down in the description. I'm Christopher Chaos. Thank you so much for watching. I'll see you guys next time. See ya.